Sedona before. In a past remote beyond all recollection. But of this I must say little, since detailed speech would but confirm those cruel slanders upon my intellect which I sometimes overhear from the whispers of the stealthy attendants around me. As given on the records, I was brought in the vigilant custody of the institution on a ground of insanity, with due formality. The state psychopathic institution in which I served 2 years. I am not now sure of the reality of certain things. The mind loses its perspective. Time and space become trivial and unreal, and echoes of a forgotten past beat insistently upon the enthralled consciousness. I know that I was greatly and permanently changed that night, which has brought me to this hell of confinement, leaving behind an unrecognizable pulp-like thing that had been a living man before. I sometimes feel strangely alone, as though I were the last man on our planet. The door hangs upon rusted iron hinges. It is fastened by means of heavy iron chains and padlocks. The ponderous chains which barred my passage. Hoping against hope, the months following were spent in futile attempts to force the complicated padlock. Like unwholesome vultures, doctors sought to deaden the agonies they could not cure. The physician with the iron gray beard who comes each day to my room was described as a highly dangerous character. The doctor locked the chain of the door behind me. Later, I told myself, I should grow to a strength and ingenuity which might enable me to unfasten the heavily chained door with ease. At last came that which I had long feared. My physician prepared a set of transmitting and receiving instruments with other scientific odds and ends for possible future use. Somewhat similar to the devices employed in wireless communication. And the bearded physician said to me, quote, that human thought consists basically of atomic or molecular motion, according to information, convertible into ether waves or radiant energy. Telepathy by means of suitable apparatus, unquote. I did not strap on the straitjacket as was customary. When the drug was administered, I realized that my actual physical danger was acute. There now ensued a series of incidents which transported me to the opposite extremes of ecstasy and horror. Incidents which I tremble to recall and speak. I will not speak.